Is your photovoltaic effect not working? Does it not add up sometimes? Are you tired of trying to make sense of it? Well, don't stress it. Particle theory of light is here. It is the more logical way of explaining light, and that's a fact. Now you can explain it with your very own photovoltaic effect.
But Brandon, what is the photovoltaic effect?
Well, Marvin, the photovoltaic effect is a creation of voltage in a material upon exposure to light.
How was it found?
Well, it was first observed by Edmond Becquerel and later reinforced by other scientists.
That's pretty cool. And how does it prove the particle theory of light?
Well, Marvin, the only way that a photovoltaic cell, other known as a solar cell, can actually work is if a light is a particle. The reason being is because photovoltaic cells cannot absorb waves. They can only absorb particles.
Like a good neighbor, Newton is there!
You're covered, Marvin.
You wave, people!
I didn't see you, man.
I hope you have insurance.
I have wave insurance, so someone can help!
I guess they're not reliable, right? Where's Huygens now? Huh?
Now that's why you need particle insurance. Newton's corpuscular theory of light is made up of small discrete particles called corpuscle, which are little particles that travel in a finite velocity. Now, Einstein's quantum theory of light is the idea that light exists as tiny particles or packets called photons that slowly emerge.
Have you ever been irritated by the nonsense of wave people? Say no more! Introducing the photoelectric paper! With the photoelectric paper, you can clean up after all the wave people. But how does photoelectric paper work? Simple! The photoelectric paper works with two parts to it. The electron part and the energy part. Energy comes in from light, bounces off a sheet of metal, and comes off, emitting an electron. But wait, there's more! The energy required to excite the electron is not based on intensity, it's based on frequency! The energy that excites these electrons come in small discrete packets called photons, and these photons collide with the electrons. But that seems like the type of physics that would happen if it was a particle. But wait, there's more! With 10 easy payments of $9.95, you can own your very own photoelectric paper! But wait, there's more!
You want to keep warm when I start telling you the cold hard truth, but you don't want to raise your heating bill. Wave people have theories, but they're dismissive and faulty, and when they try to back it up, they're circumstantial at best. Introducing the Snuggie, the blanket with sleeves. Buy yours now for the low price of $12.99. It'll keep you warm when I tell you the cold truth. Waves are vibration in particles, and in space there are no particles, so how can light travel through space? Light can travel through a vacuum, but sound can't travel through a vacuum, thus emphasizing light can't be a wave. Waves are a relationship of entities from A to B, and traveling from A to B, you would encounter copious constructive and destructive interference, but light doesn't encounter any of these. So how can light be a wave? Get your Snuggie now! Remember, for the low price of $12.99!
Disclaimer, everything shown here improves theory without a better one. Your improvement can't be disproved, so everything you know, especially the easiest, every hypothetical concept, blah, 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 so starting on like that.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, with Marvin Funes, world-renowned particle physicist. So tell me, Marvin, a lot of people have been talking about ether and how light travels through it. Can you elaborate on that?
Well, Mr. Patel, people have talked about the ether. But I gotta say one thing, though. Ether's very theoretical. It can't be proven. There's no way to determine that there's such thing as an invisible medium which light can travel through space. Doesn't make sense. And when talking about it, it's just unrealistic. You gotta go literally against quantum mechanics, which is the foundation of everything we stand for in today's society. Lorentz tried to prove it, but was unable to produce any evidence to solidify his reasoning. Einstein had theories as to whether or not ether can exist for the sole fact that it would have to be an impulse in energy, and ether is immobile, so how can something have impulse in energy according to Einstein?
And sitting across from me is Brandon Arroyo, alumni from Brown University. So tell me, Brandon, photovoltaic energy is big in the solar world. How does that work?
Well, Mr. Patel, the way solar panels absorb sunlight is by the particles of light are absorbed by the solar panels. The way this works is that the solar panels contain little particles of silicon, and when the sunlight hits them, it sends electrons from the outer shell to the inner shell, and then inner shell electrons go up to the outer shell, and this creates voltage.
With me here today is Marlon Sanchez, professor at University of Chicago. So, Newton and Einstein are major players in the light game, but tell me, what do they do? What is their significance?
Known for his law of gravitation, physicist Isaac Newton realized that light had frequency-like properties in which he used a prism to split sunlight into separate components.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's a wrap. We hope you had a good time on this show, Light as a Particle, featuring Brandon Arroyo, Mara Funes, and the ever-so-delightful Marlon Sanchez.